In this video, we are going to learn how to collect polyps and medusa of the cnidarian class Hydrozoa. Hydrozoa are very abundant in shallow waters. You can collect them by snorkeling or diving. They live on a variety of substrates, such as rocks, algae, but also a variety of animals, such as crabs, hermit crabs, sponges, and even fishes. Colonial hydrozoans can form beautiful big colonies, easily visible with the naked eye, or very small and delicate ones, very hard to spot. If the species you're interested in is very small, then it's probably best to collect the substrate it grows on, even if during the sampling you cannot see it. You will need to inspect the substrate under a stereoscope once you are in the lab. If you spot a big colony, collect it with a little bit of its substrate and put it in a Falcon tube or a Ziploc bag. You can prepare multiple labeled bags or tubes if you're planning to collect hydrids at different depths. Caprolids or other animals can feed on hydrids. So once in the lab, it is important to inspect the colonies and eliminate them before they damage the specimens. Keep in mind that the hydrids will be in good conditions for only a few hours after collecting. For collecting the medusa, you will need a plankton net with an end jar and a mesh opening of about 100 microns and a few wide mouth sample jars. Medusa of the class Hydrozoa are extremely abundant, but very small, inconspicuous, and understudied. During the sampling, make sure the mouth of the plankton net is underwater at all times. Once you collect the plankton, empty the end jar into the sample jar and put it in a cooler. In the laboratory, divide the samples in glass bowls. Let the plankton settle for a few minutes and sort it under a stereoscope. Hydromedusa can be hard to see even under the stereoscope, and especially when copepods or other taxa are very abundant. Hydromedusa, however, have a characteristic swimming pulse that can help you spot them. Once you see a medusa, isolate it from the rest of the plankton using a pipette and put it in a petri dish with clean seawater. You can now try to identify it using the appropriate bibliographic sources.